Hey, what's up, guys? It's Shark Record Films, and today I'm here to show you guys another television set. Today I have a 13-inch RCA Color Track television from 1983. I particularly like this set a lot. It's from 1983 and it uses a remote. Check this out. I mean, you don't have any big knobs or anything. It's really nice, actually. Today I'm not using a little the little spinning pad that I usually use. I have the television on some pieces of cardboard so I can slide it around and show you guys in detail what this thing's all about. So first off, let's take a look at this little part right here. So obviously this thing is used by remote, but there's this little door here where you can see where the buttons are. It's a little bit hard to see. Let me get a flashlight. So if we can take a look here, you can see there's eight buttons here. Should be nine, but there's no button in the middle. So right here in the top right corner, you got a what says volume. Some of the words are kind of washed out from old age, but it says volume, and there's supposed to be an up arrow and a down arrow. And over here, all I can barely make out channel. So if it follows the same pattern, I should assume this is channel up, then channel down. And then you got select lock, erase, and add. So that leaves only one more function, which is on and off. So this must be the power button. And that's about it. There's nothing else there. Yep, that's it. So, go ahead and turn this off, close that door. And let's not forget this little detail right here. Color track, channel lock remote. So, 1983, it's kind of hard to think that TVs like this were coming out in 1983. Kind of crazy. So, I think it's time to turn the TV around and see what we have back here. Let's turn the TV to its side so you guys can get a nice, good look at the TV. It looks very nice. If you didn't notice, right there's an aux jack, so you could plug headphones or speakers into here. Pretty cool that a TV has that. Not all my TVs have that, so I appreciate it when it does. So you can see the back side. Oof. All right, there we go. So there's quite a few things going on here on the back, a lot more than in front, clearly. So let's first zoom in here. So we've got the back. We got the caution. We got I'm assuming that's caution in Spanish. Focus screen, for repairing a TV and whatnot. RCA Corporation. Let's see what else we can see. This is where all the very interesting stuff is. About right here is where all the interesting things are. So starting at the top, you've got manufactured February 1983, Spanish or French or whatever. RCA Bloomington, Indiana, USA. Model number RCA model number EGC339FR. Right here, it's a bit curled. It just says printed in the USA. Serial number. There you go. But it was made in February 1983, which was a very long time ago. So that's all. Manual, remote, everything there. Everything you need to know. Let's zoom out just a little bit. This does have a little antenna here, which let me just unplug this. And I'll save this for later, but let's take a look at what's going on up there. So it's kind of hard to make out. I think I'm gonna have to zoom in just a little bit. All right. Over here we have a VHF, very high frequency. Here we have UHF, ultra high frequency. Over here we have 75 ohms, 500 ohms. This is usually the jack that everybody uses, But I have heard from another viewer that using these gives you better picture quality. And I'm inclined to believe him, but I will try that out someday, okay? So stay tuned for that. But very simple. Most TVs have this, nothing too special. We do have something a little special over here. Take a look. Can you guys read that? It says cable and norm. That's a switch. This is for back in the day. There was a cable and normal. I actually kind of forgot what this meant, but I have it set to normal. But I'm inclined to believe that one of them has a better quality. Yeah, I don't have that much to say about that. I can't remember too much, so let's just move on. I have over here. Oh, that's kind of hard. I think I'm gonna have to pour this thing on the ground and then see if I have anything over here to look at. The cable's in the way, so I can just move this aside. Oh, just... All right. So there we go. We got a nice view that says bias, blue, green, red, RB, red, blue, green, and then that right there. And then at the bottom says drive, and then a V slash HT bias. Over here we've got hold, we've got a setup. In normal out serve, that's us peaking. Then you got your controls and stuff. There's a vertical hold up there, but you can't see the vertical. And yeah, there we got a screw. We got these things, these little things that you can use to wrap the cable around. Which is quite useful. I wasn't using that in storage, but I will now. All right, well, I think that's all there is to show for the back. Now I'll go ahead and turn the TV over so we can check out the remote and later on test the TV. So let's go ahead and get the remote out here. Let's take a look at the remote. Now, as you might figure, there isn't too much to show about this remote here. Again, this is from RCA, don't forget. So, very minimal, very simple. We have volume, up, down, channel, up, down, mute, and then on and off. Very simple. Up front, we have just nothing, you know, just the infrared sensors, whatever. And nothing on the back. I guess they're supposed to, this is supposed to. Kind of be like spongy, you know, because it's going to be sliding around and not scraping, but it's obviously gone now. And then you use this thing to pop out and, the remotes and whatnot. I really, you're not supposed to have different types of bat. You're supposed to have, if you're going to have Duracell, you have to have them all Duracell or this one company, they all got to be it. Don't mix and match batteries, but I don't have any more batteries. These are all I have. So, just for the purpose of showing you guys this video, that's all I got. I don't think there's anything too interesting here. There's just a few cables back there that you can look at. You can see the little green circuit board or whatever. So, yeah, that's about it. Oh, we've got some information here you guys might want to take a look at. Pause the video. Fine, blah, blah, blah. If you guys want to take a look at that, there you go. And now let's slide this thing back on and turn the TV on. How about that? Now, if I was correct, I think that there is an on and off power button over here. So I'll go ahead and see if that works just to try it out. Well, I was wrong. That's not a power on and off button. That leads me to believe that that must be the mute button. So let's turn the TV on here. Well, the volume definitely does work. Let's go ahead and try the mute button. The mute button definitely works. The mute doesn't completely mute the volume though. It only it drops the volume very low, but you can still hear the static. Let's see if I turn the volume back up. It's back to normal. This gets rid of the mute. Let's go to channel 3. There you go. Let's check out if the mute button works here. If this is mute. What? Don't know. Well, I feel like none of the buttons work on the on this thing here, which is a little bit odd. So I can't change the channels here. I'll have to check the manual. If you guys thought I was joking, you're wrong. I was being completely serious. I have the manual here for not just my particular television, but both of my particular television sets. Here, right here, is a 1984 Capehart that I have, and this is a 1984 RCA, I guess. This is a 1983 model. I'm assuming, since it says June 1984 up here, this must be the 1984 model of this television. But I don't think that's much changed in 1 year, so I'm guessing it still works. I'm sure the chassis and whatnot is all the same, you know? So, I'm not gonna take a look at this right now, not on video, that'll just be a waste of time. So I'll go ahead and put this back, but I will get that sorted out later, see what the deal is. For right now, I wanna try a few things. First things first, I wanna try out this little cable. What are these things called again? I forgot. Converter box. I want to try this converter box out, see if I can get some analog, or I mean a digital broadcasting or whatever on see what I can get. So let me just go ahead and pop this up here and let me see what I can do. Let me turn this thing around and get everything plugged in. All right, there we go. Now we still got one more thing to plug in, which is the antenna in. So I've actually got the antenna and everything here, which I forgot to show you guys. I'll show you guys right now. If I remember correctly, I'm pretty sure this is the actual antenna that I bought this TV with. And I didn't tell you guys how, when, or where the story of when I bought this TV was, but you guys don't really. It's not that interesting. I just got this TV for $20 off Craigslist, which is sums up all the story pretty much right there. But this is the little box thing that it came with, and I actually have another quick connect F plug transformer right here that I got from the dollar store just a few weeks ago, and from the looks of it, it's exactly the same. Well, upside down, so it'd be like this. Except this one's gold plated or whatever, which I think looks kind of cheaper. But I would like to know if these actually work better than the old ones, or if the old ones work better than the new ones. Because I'm assuming the new ones are kind of crappier, but that'll be for another video. Or the same video. I don't know. You guys will find out. But let's go ahead and plug this into the converter box, place the propped antenna on the TV, and let's see if we can get anything. There we go. Let's turn the TV around. All right, so if I did everything the way I was supposed to, this should work. So let's start off by turning the television on. There. I have it set to channel 3, so let's turn the converter box on. Oh, it looks like I don't have any more batteries in this remote. Crap. Well, I'll be right back, guys. Don't worry. I'm really glad you didn't go anywhere. So I've got batteries now. Let's see if this works. Whoopsie. All right, so it says no signal, unable to tune this channel. Try adjusting the antenna to improve signal strength or perform a new channel scan. So I haven't used this box in a while. But let's see what I have to do. Oh, it looks like we're done.
Is to make people think that they're getting a great deal.
This is MeTV, Washington, D.C.'s home for memorable entertainment television.
That means like this now happening more and more as...
For you, it doesn't take much of this, you know. And the spot for you there. Cheers!
Por uno de visita y son cuartos en la general. Real Madrid 2-0.
These are in the average litter.
Seven.
It's memorable. That's me.
Less than 35 cents a day.
Save big this week at Hyundai.
You could be this guy.
Dr. David Banner, physician scientist.
Oh, that's all my channels. All right, guys. Well, I hope you guys enjoyed that. I think it's time to switch over to the trusty old pattern generator to get the real results of how the TV's performing right now. So I'm gonna have to go ahead and unplug everything that I have right now and just plug everything into this. So let's go ahead and do that real quickly. Let me get this cable out. I have to go ahead and unplug the converter box. Go ahead and plug in the Tenma pattern generator's power supply like that. Then we're gonna go ahead and plug in the Tenma pattern generator. Take this thing off. We're not gonna need this. Have to unscrew this back here. Alright, everything seems to be set up, so let's go ahead and turn the pattern generator on first, and let's turn the TV on. Should have made it channel 3. Let's turn the volume on. Oh, that's chroma. The picture doesn't look bad at all, to be honest. Alright. Well, it could, the TV could probably use a little more, refining and adjustments. I think I will, adjust it later, but I need to get a reference of the right colors. As I was actually, adjusting the color scheme on my Sony Trinitron about a few weeks ago, because I got a Sony Trinitron recently, haha. And, I hooked up a splitter to the old Tenma pattern generator and connected one to the flat screen that I have and one to the Trinitron, which I was trying to reconfigure, refix the color on. And I used the flat screen as a reference because it was all the colors are fine on the flat screen. Don't quote me on that because, I mean, I like CRTs a lot more. I think they're really cool. But, I use that as a reference, so I might have to get the splitter again and use this with flat screen to try to fix color. When I was watching the over-the-air analog broadcasting on the old converter box, the color was a bit too saturated. I think the contrast was a bit messed up. One thing I did not show you guys in this video is the controls for everything is actually down here. Let me get the old light out here. So, see if you guys can see that. You guys see that? There's color, there's tint, black level, and picture. So there are the four, and that's all of them. Right below the screen there, and yep, that's pretty much it. I think this is going to be the end of the video. I hope you guys enjoyed watching this video. I hope you guys go ahead and like, leave a comment if you guys have any questions or if you have a TV like this or this one specifically. Tell me about it in the comments below, and subscribe if you enjoyed this video and if you want more videos like this in the future. And I'll see you guys in the next one. Bye.